get to the chopper. Who the hell is King Willy? I'm the one that got away, and it wants the next evolution. This is my review for the Predator 4 film franchise.
A-V-N.
It's Headphones Neil!
What's up, guys? Headphones Neil here, back with another film franchise review, and in this case, it's going to be the four film franchise for Predator. So, having never seen the films, I thought I would finally get around to watching them, see what all the hubbub is, see what the big deal is, how they progress over time, and basically just see if they hold up, see how the stories will go and all that good stuff. So with that being said, I want to say that for the most part I did enjoy all the films. In watching them, after I finished the second one, I originally thought that it was going to be the lesser of the films, but the ending gave me hope, and in general that actually prompted me to want to watch another film franchise, so I'll get to that at the end of the review. But overall, I want to say, as far as the films go, the first one was good at setting up the idea of the Predator. The second one was okay in that we learned that there was more than just the one Predator, because it feels like it would be a strange waste of energy to just send one spy, I guess, from a race of beings that are bent on taking over planets to take care of the whole, or to research the whole planet, because what if something happens and the research is lost, or basically what if something is inhospitable, or he needs backup or things like that. So the second film kind of solves that problem in that there were multiple predators on the planet, and basically a whole nest of them doing research to take over the planet. The third one was kind of a strange one. It added a good set of lore as far as being able to survive the predators, escape from them, their higher social hierarchy, and their evolution. But it was kind of strange as far as the people randomly showing up there. I don't know that we saw how they got there, so that was kind of one of those weird explanations for why they were on the planet. So it felt kind of out of place in the grand scheme of things. So in watching the four films, if you actually skip Predator 3, it feels like would not have missed anything, because when you watch the first one, you're like, okay, there was a one Predator, are there more, where did they come from, what's going on? So you go and jump into Predator 2, and you learn that there are more on the planet, they're doing their research, and they end up leaving the planet. And then you jump into 4, and you say, or into the Predator, and you basically learn that they've still been around, they've been working on their evolution, and that's why there were multiple predators there, and the group that left passed on their research. They were able to evolve and come back because of their invincibility abilities. That's why they were able to stay hidden and continue their research and continue from there. So overall, that all worked. I found the general premise behind the films and the general presentations of the films well done. I like the progressing evolution of the point of view from the predators with their lasers, the weaponry, the thermal vision, and all of that. In the last film, I didn't see that we had too much of it, but still, overall, it generally worked, even with the consistently rotating cast. I think in the fourth film, there were talks of Arnold Schwarzenegger reprising his role as Dutch, but he wanted a larger role, and it didn't work out. I guess he could have been maybe the main villain of the bad guys, or it would have felt jammed in, basically, but it could have also transitioned maybe into the Alien versus Predator franchise or something along those lines. But in any case, I want to say that there wasn't really much. I mean, overall, when you watch them together, they are good films. If you watch them on their own, the first one and the third one actually stand out as the better films. The first one generally just works because you have a predator, you have a bunch of mercenaries trying to find out what's going on. He could have been the last of his race. They don't know what happened, but they all are Dutch manages to escape. And the third one, it stands out as its own film, mostly because you have all these people being dropped onto a random planet, being hunted by predators. You learn that humans are being dropped there as predators of their species to fight against these other alien predators, and it's possible to escape them via the story being told by Lawrence Fishburne's character. So on its own, the film stands out, but in the grand scope of things, it was a very minimal progression of story, which was told better in The Predator. So as far as The Predator goes and Predator 2, they were probably the lesser of the films just because they didn't necessarily tell enough of a new story, but they finished with enough of a main point. Like, for example, Predator 2 told the story of multiple predators, and Predator, or The Predator, aka Predator 4, kind of introduced and resolved the idea of the evolution of the predator. So all in all, that worked well. So that's really all there is to say about the film. I want to say that they generally worked. I liked them. It was enjoyable. In general, I probably would give the movies a grade of about a B to B plus, maybe. They were good films, not great. They were loosely tied together, so if they were all told now, they would have probably had more of a consistent storytelling and story arc along the lines of a Star Wars or Marvel Cinematic Universe or even a Harry Potter to tie them together a little bit better. Because, you know, the first two started before the 2000s and the second two came in after the 2000s, it kind of spreads apart a little bit more, but you can tell that in the later two films, they're trying to better resolve the story, or at least not, maybe not the third one, but in the fourth one, they're trying to better tie together the storylines with multiple aliens and the evolution of the predators. So tie all those various points together into another film. So with that being said, as far as the next film franchise, I'm going to watch the main Alien films. So Alien, Aliens, Alien 3, and I think the fourth one is Alien Covenant, or Alien Requiem. I forget which one is the fourth one. So I'll take a look as I talk. I know there was Prometheus and then the sequel, Prometheus was Alien Covenant. So in the main Alien films, the fourth one was Alien Resurrection. So I'm going to watch those four Alien films because at the ending of Predator 2, we see the wall of trophies on the alien ship that Danny Glover comes across, and we see the exoskeleton for the xenomorph. So that got me thinking that there was gonna be, or that was a nifty little Easter egg for a crossover film, which they didn't do until I think in the 2000s. So I guess they didn't do that as soon as people thought they would. So Alien versus Predator came out in, looks like, 2004. Whereas Predator 2, where this was originally teased, came out in 1990, so a nice 14-year jump. But that's going to be the ultimate completion of the film watching, where I'm going to watch Alien versus Predator and Alien Covenant, or Alien, I already forgot what I said, but whatever the sequel to Alien versus AVP was. But I'm gonna watch the four Alien films just because that got me thinking, because of Predator 2. So I have seen Alien and Aliens. I think I started Alien 3, and if what the rumors say, Alien 3 was supposed to be the lower or lesser of the films, but I'm going to give them all a shot now just because I have a little bit more understanding of the Predator films. Having seen Alien, I'm going to go in watching the Alien director's cut, but I want to give it a fresh pair of eyes just to get through it and understand it. Same thing with Aliens, and then finish out the series just so I understand that before I get into Alien versus Predator and its sequel, to watch everything all in one go. So that's all there is for this particular review. It's one of those things where I wanted to give the films a watch to get caught up on them, having never seen any of the Predator films, but having heard the line, "get to the chopper," which is said by Dutch in the first Predator film. I heard who the hell is King Willy before, never really attributing it to anything, which is from Predator 2. The rest of the other two films didn't really have anything that stood out as, you know, standout lines, so I can't really say that there was anything special about them. But I included the lines that were in the intro as far as what sounded like related lines along the lines of what the first two films did. So that is all there is to say about that. So that's all there is for this particular review. So if you have any questions, comments, feedback, or anything like that, you can find me on Twitter at PatelN01. If you're a patron, you can comment on the post at patreon.com/PatelN01. And of course, you can get subscription links to support the show, quick access to various posts and all of that by visiting the website at headphonesneil.reviews. But that's all there is for this particular episode. Thanks for tuning in. And until next.